In this section, we're going to look at calculating markup based on selling price. In the previous section, we worked on markup based on cost, and now we're going to look at markup based on selling price. We use the same formula, cost plus markup equals selling price, except when we were working on markup based on cost, the base was on cost, and now calculating markup based on selling price moves the base to the selling price. Markup on cost is often used by manufacturers. However, retailers often compare business operations to sales revenue and therefore oftentimes prefer to use markup on selling price. So let's take a look at calculating some markup based on selling price problems. In this first example, we have items cost $185 and it has a selling price of $250. Compute the percent markup on selling price. Because the markup is on selling price, that dictates where the base or the 100% is going. They're asking us to find the markup rate. So we can plug in the rest of the information, cost of $185, selling price of $250. Since we know two of the three values in this formula, we can calculate the markup by subtracting the cost from the selling price. So we now have a dollar amount. And given that we have a dollar amount, this will act as the part that we then can solve for the rate given our base of $250. So solving for a rate, we take part divided by base, giving us a decimal and converting that into a percentage. The markup rate based on selling price is 26%. In this next problem, we have the cost and selling price of an item, and the question is asking us, what is the percent markup based on selling price? Based on selling price tells us where the 100% in our base in this percentage problem is going to fall. We're looking for the markup percentage. Replacing cost and selling price with the values given in the problem, just like the last problem, because we know two of the three values, we can solve for the markup by subtracting the cost from the markup, leaving the difference of $239.50. And we now can solve for the rate of the markup, given we have a part and using the base of this problem. To solve for rate, again, we take part divided by base, converting that into a percentage. We get a 22.7% markup. Here we have another problem that's asking us to determine the selling price. We're given the cost and we're told that the markup rate is based on selling price. Using our foundation formula, because it's based on selling price, that's where the 100% and our base value will go. They're telling us we have a markup rate of 40% and we're trying to find the selling price. Before we use the item cost information, we can solve for the percentage that the cost is. In other words, what plus 40% gives us the total of 100%. That missing percentage is 60%, and that will help when we fill in the rest of the information. We're looking for the base. The only other information we know is the cost, which is going to be treated as our part, given that we know a rate associated with it, which will allow us to solve for the base. So we have our part, the $209.95, and a rate. Looking for the base, we will take part divided by rate to calculate base. And the resulting answer for the selling price of this item is $349.92. In this next problem, very similar to the last one, we're given a cost. The markup rate is based on selling price and it's 12%, and the question is asking us what the selling price is. Using our foundation selling price formula, we'll fill in our percentages because it's based on selling price. That's the location of our base and 100%. We're given a markup rate of 12%. Because of the 100% location, we know the base. The other information given is that the cost value is $3,560. To fill out this missing percentage, that then would give us a rate apart, and we could solve then for the base, we need to answer the question, what plus 12% equals 100? Solving for the unknown, we'll subtract a 12% from 100, which gives us 88%. And solving for the base, we take part divided by rate to give us our base, or in this case, the selling price of $4,045.45. Here we have another example where we have the markup given, and the percent markup based on selling price is 75%, and the problem is asking us to determine the cost. To help us organize that information, we use our selling price formula, plugging in the information given because it's based on selling price. There's our 100%. The percent markup is 75%. Because of the 100% location on selling price, that's our base. We're given a markup amount. We're trying to find the cost, but we have two unknowns on our cost. So the first step we need to do is to find our base, given that we have a rate and a part. So our first step for the base, we will take part divided by rate, gives us a selling price of $4.20. And now that we know a markup and a selling price, we can determine our cost by taking the selling price minus the markup, will leave us with a cost of $1.05. In this next example, similar to the last one, we're given a markup, a percent markup based on selling price, and they're asking us for the cost. Plugging that information into our selling price formula, because markup is based on selling price, that's the location of 100%. The percent markup is 28%. 100% is our base location. Our markup is given. So to help us solve for the cost, we can use this pair, the rate and the part, to help us find the base. First, base is calculated by taking part, which is the markup, divided by the markup rate, gives us a selling price of $102.68. And once we have that, we can take the selling price, subtract the markup to leave us with the cost, $73.93.